several, country parks, Royden, Thurstonston, Arrow Park, Easton, and lots of picturesque farmland through which there is a myriad of pathways that residents can walk on. But, in total contrast, Wirral has many deprived areas in desperate need of redevelopment. Much of central Birkenhead, New Ferry, Rockford, fall into this category.
I will be making an offer for the lady who to deserve it. Forgive me for mentioning that, but my point is simply that the arguments of those speaking on behalf of the lady are being paid handsomely and should not be weighed equally with those of your residents who do genuinely love this place. As a has an asking price of just £160,000, which is a lot less than the
is the main route for the emergency vehicles. Ambulances frequently transfer patients to Arrowpark Hospital, often in an emergency situation, to the specialty hospitals in Liverpool and Aintree. The hospitals used are Broadbury Hospital, Liverpool Heart and Chest Hospital, Royal Liverpool University Hospital, Alderhead Children's Hospital and Aintree Hospital, which is the main major trauma centre. The Liverpool Heart and Chest Hospital is one of the largest specialist heart and lung centres in the UK, with over 115,000 people on their services. Aintree Hospital provides specialist life-saving treatment for patients who will be transferred directly from the scene of an accident or from a
decision.
expensive. Not perhaps in the context of London prices, but certainly for around these parts. What Leverhulme declares that certain percentages of the houses constructed will be, in quotes, affordable. We should not be fooled by this, as the definition of affordable in this context is 80% of the average house price in the locale. So, given this scenario, who are the potential beneficiaries of the Leverhulme plans? They are, of course, Leverhulme Estates and their wealthy trustees, the developers and builders who will actually construct these houses, plus the wealthy people fortunate enough to be able to afford such dwellings. We must appreciate the greenbelt land on which these houses might be built will be sold at eye-watering prices by Leverhulme to the builders and developers. Because of what greenbelt is and where it is. This obliges the builders to build expensive luxury dwellings, providing them with the lucrative profit margins that ensue, far more lucrative than the regular three-bedroom setting. So whilst these wealthy people are benefiting, the people for whom the housing need is greatest are being forgotten. These are, of course, the first-time buyers and citizens of moderate incomes, the very people that our society should be concerned about. This is not London, and the house prices we are talking about will be well beyond the reach of most people in this room, apart, of course, from those promoting Leverhulme's plans. Leverhulme talk about the pressing need for housing on the Wirral and how their grandiose and altruistic plans will meet that need. Where is the evidence for that housing need? Whilst forecasting the future is an extremely difficult task, the best indicators for the future are what has actually happened in the past. We've already heard that the recent population census tells that the population on the Wirral in the last 10 years has grown by precisely 417 people. That amounts to an increase.